The meeting between President Yoweri Kaguta Museveni and the International Criminal Court Chief Prosecutor Karim Khan at State Lodge Nakasero comes after the court closed its investigation into alleged crimes against humanity and war crimes committed by the rebel Lord's Resistance Army in northern Uganda. The two discussed, among other issues, Uganda's importance as a well-respected state party to the ICC on Friday.
From an excellent meeting with the President of the Republic of Uganda, President Museveni, we discussed a wide range of issues, the importance of Uganda as a very well-respected state party to the ICC. It was the government that referred the situation of the Lord's Resistance Army and the Ugandan situation many years ago. And as many Ugandans will know, there's a new effort, given my application for confirmation hearing in absence, to circulate the document containing charges more broadly in Uganda. This is because of an order from the judges, and the registry is doing that right now. But with the President, of course, we discussed a lot of other issues. The region is critically important. It's a region that has difficulties. Sudan, one is seeing very concerning reports.
Uganda ratified the Rome Statute in 2002, and in January 2004, it referred the situation in its territory since July 1, 2002, to the court, allowing it to exercise its jurisdiction over crimes listed in the Rome Statute committed on the territory of Uganda or by its nationals. As the court jeers for Kony's trial in absentia, Khan is praising the Ugandan government for its vital role in putting an end to the Lord's Resistance Army insurgency in northern Uganda and its support to ICC in prosecuting the war criminals.
To come together based upon common ground of humanity has never perhaps been as vivid or as such an imperative as it is now, and I was very grateful to have quite some time with the President, and he showed his knowledge of history, his understanding of the region, and I think collectively the Rome Statute principles that Uganda has signed up to, that is part of its culture, part of its legal system, combined also with the strategic approach of Uganda for stability, for security, and the respect for these fundamental rights. So it was a very productive meeting. I'm very grateful to the President for giving me so much of his time, and I hope to have many more opportunities to come to Uganda in the period ahead.
In November 2022, the International Criminal Court's chief prosecutor had judges confirm charges against Ugandan warlord Joseph Kony, even though he remains at large. Kony launched a bloody rebellion more than three decades ago, seeking to impose his own version of the Ten Commandments in northern Uganda, unleashing a campaign of terror that spread to several other countries. The Hague-based ICC issued an arrest warrant for Kony in 2005 on allegations of war crimes and crimes against humanity, and U.S. President Barack Obama in 2011 launched a small number of U.S. troops to help regional armies try to capture him. Khan said he had asked judges for authorization to hold a hearing to confirm the charges against Kony in his absence. Khan then explained that suspects cannot be tried in absentia, the ICC, but it is possible to hold confirmation hearings while they are still fugitives. Confirming the charges against Kony would make it easier and quicker to put him on trial should he be captured. The LRA's campaign of violence has claimed more than 100,000 lives and seen 60,000 children abducted. The violence eventually spread to Sudan, the Democratic Republic of Congo, and Central African Republic. The allegations against Kony in the arrest warrant include murder, cruel treatment, enslavement, rape, and attacks against civilian population. In 2021, the ICC convicted an LRA child soldier turned commander, Dominic Ongweng, of war crimes and crimes against humanity and sentenced him to 25 years in jail. The ICC was set up in 2002 to bring perpetrators of the world's worst crimes to justice, but has been criticized for choosing many of its cases from African nations.